Hello, it's me again, and I'm just going to see what... Okay, I know how vinegar and baking soda make a volcano-like thing.
What kind of reaction it makes.
Yeah, but I wanted to see what would happen if I put some peroxide in it.
If peroxide does anything different. Yeah. Go ahead and see if it reacts, see if the peroxide reacts with the baking soda. Put just a tiny pinch in there.
And I use some coloring in it.
Just a pinch with your finger, just a tiny one. Okay, so it don't react with it. And put you just a tiny bit of vinegar here and peroxide and just pour it in the cap and then put part of the cap in there. Or here, let's just mix it in the cap. And then we'll put a drop of peroxide in there or two. Okay, no reaction. But, so now go ahead and pour you some vinegar in there. So we've got no reaction with those two, and she put some green food coloring in there.
Doesn't make it work as good.
Does it work better or
no,
less?
Way less.
Alright, well let's try it with just vinegar for then. I'll dump this out for you.
Why is there a fly in there?
I don't know. I'm sure if it was alive it wishes it wouldn't in there. It out. Here, tell them something. Tell them about your super volcano that you're going to do tonight.
Well,
that you're doing it
with yeast and sugar. We're going to do a super volcano. Yeah, yeah. With like 3 liter, or is it 2.5?
It's a gallon.
Oh.
It's an old.
Oh, it's an old thing?
Yeah. And we're making the paper mache tonight, hopefully. So just put the amount that you had in there. Don't overdo it. All right. Go ahead, that's close enough. And I think it reacted a little bit more with the peroxide.
Normally does better than that.
Now, here, talk to him a second about your super volcano.
Super volcano goes boom.
I'm gonna let you try something with fire. Because, tell them what the difference in H2O and hydrogen peroxide.
Well, hydrogen peroxide has one more,
oxygen.
Yeah, oxygen.
Oxygen, atom. So it's H2O3.
Yeah.
That's what peroxide is. And this is only like 3% hydrogen peroxide. It's mostly water. So you're not going to get a big reaction. I've got to find a lighter. Do you know where the lighters are?
Nope.
That's a now, this time we're going to trap the, get you some Dawn dishwashing detergent, and we're going to trap those bubbles. It won't take much. That was probably too much. And we're going to go ahead and put your hydrogen peroxide in. Now that's only making bubbles because of it trapping them. And then we're going to put your vinegar in. A little bit more. And now in theory, it should release extra oxygen from the water, so we should be able to make this flame go higher. How about you stand up and get back a little bit? Don't get back too far. You got it? Good?
good.
Now, as those oxygen, see, y'all see what the flame looks like. And say oxygen just feeds flames. So we'll see if it's going to do anything different here.
Put a little bit of alcohol in there, it would work.
Yeah, when it's popping, come here and watch it pop one of the bubbles. It's extra oxygen in those bubbles. It's making it go up just a little higher. See?
Ugh.
Not much, but a little. We should have turned the lights up. But anyway, let me show you the reason we decided to use. We'll show them later. Well, I guess that's good enough for now. Now you know that it reacts just a little bit different. So, bye-bye now.